Welcome on it, you can take it. to go with them and put a seat. Go home to your family and tell them how much the Lord has done for you and how he has been blessing on you. God sets the lonely in families. He leads for Christmas for singing, but the rebellious living the sons of God shame. And now we have a grant for you, Lord, and for children.
Thank you. we come together, whether it be two people in marriage, joining, becoming one like Bud Light, whether tall, short, whatever. Whether we come together as people and family, in the way that we normally traditionally understand it, children and all the rest, or whether it's family in a much wider sense, there's something very unique about it. And we can have all sorts of things happen in family. Things can go right, things can go well, things can go wrong. Tonight we had a little bit of an incident with a senior player that went wild, as you noticed. Caring part of the family, he said, hey, we can't get these guys to all his practice and not finish the dance. Can we find another CD? It's not going to fault. So we raced around everywhere. We did something as family together. And it was good. And so let's show our appreciation for this team. Men and women have tended to be rather sort of reflective on each other. Sometimes we like to joke. Most of the jokes aren't too serious, although they do have other times that might be. One man said a woman has the last word in any argument. Anything a man says after that is the beginning of a new argument. I would say to the man who said that, he was looking for a new argument. It's a dangerous thing. But let's look at what love has been defined as, because I think tonight as we come to this whole subject and the end of the series, it would be good to reflect for a moment. Plato described it as a grave mental illness or disease. Something they say is blind. Then they put it in brackets. Marriage is the real life. Love is that emotion which is not true until it returns. Love is that delightful interval between meeting a beautiful girl and discovering that she looks like a hat, said John Barrymore. I would like to suggest the other way. Love has been defined as the most supreme word in the human language, used by names to seduce, by fools for comfort, and by most men to placate the female of the species. And then a little small love is also considered the only fire for which there is no insurance. Love is the only game that teachers play in both women. Love is what makes marriage possible. Heaven makes it last. Love is a temporary insanity, said one writer, curable by marriage. Another says the tie that blinds, and if you don't think it's true, you ought to try to do marriage counselling. And you ask them, the two people, what is your ideal of your partner? You ask each person, and the two of them will tell you things that you know are unrealistic. Because if you even know the other person very slightly, you will know that it's almost totally unrealistic. I have a slight problem when I'm going to solve. So here we are. Love is like that. One woman who was a little frustrated with her family situation said this: sound travels slowly. Sometimes the things you say when your kids are teenagers don't reach them until they're in their 40s. I don't know, 40 of my daughters haven't reached their 40s yet. There are some bits of advice that I'm sure they've always picked up on. I'm grateful for the fact they have. But love is a peculiar thing. Friendship, relationships, into God is extremely interested in the come back to it. The scripture that was read for us by Ian.
No.
He asks us to give, but he promises in return that he will give to us and he will be concerned with us as like we are children. He said, you're no longer slaves. He said, you have become my children when you ask me to die. You have become my children that they can receive the best that I can offer. So he's interested in that. And if you look at one of the families that's represented here, and look, if you are in a position where you're really on your own because of the destructive things that have happened, I can tell you right now, from my own experience, when I first became a Christian, my life situation was not an easy one. I didn't become a Christian because I felt I needed to. I didn't think God was important. I didn't. So if you want God. But the moment I became a Christian, the moment I got to know what God's interest in me, and that I understood His intention for me to be part of His family, the dynamics in my own family started to change. And they were quite significant changes. Yes, I did love. Yes, I did get angry sometimes when I shouldn't have. But they started to change. There was something very profound happening. That the God shaped power that was inside me started to get filled. And the moment it started to get filled, immediately it was changing. I remember an incident where I got very, very angry with some of our friends in our family. I got extremely frustrated. And I took an action that I today regret. I grabbed my brother by his collar on the front. I lifted him up against the beach and I yelled out to my father, come and see what this rat son of yours has done. He just smashed my watch. But I can tell you this, God swiped all my appearance, even though I thought I was wrong. Might sound strange, I was meant to be his son, meant to be adopted into his family. He said he'd give me. But I can look back now and say, I appreciate that. Because I don't think I would be in a relationship with my parents today, like I am. We have a very good relationship. He said that the temptation for me was to do things that would become totally destructive. But, see, God got on my face. I did the thing, the classic thing, I dived for the Bible. I opened it up, just sort of opened up my eyes closed and said, God, you showed me something that I could do to my parents. I think God was going to lift a huge grin on his face. I meant that because I looked down and under my finger and it said, obey your father and your mother. I'm on your father and your mother. I just read the word that was on my God, it's one of the babies. On your father and your mother. I felt that was totally unjust. God should be on my side. You see, but God is not interested in being on somebody's side. He's interested in all the people of this world. He's interested that they might be part of his family and that he can help the families of those who he loves. I don't know why he's saying that. I don't particularly want to hear that. Because, see, I don't want to be angry. I thought I had a lot of anger. It was a hard deal. It was a face. But the other thing that God's really interested in terms of family, he's interested in every one of us. In our own families, and whole families, not part families, would have the right to share his eternity. Now, none of us have the right way, just natural sort of fact that we've been born. There's lots of people go around the group today saying, no, God's got a life, so if you end up with me, you can't be with you. It's very awful. The trouble is, if they let people into this heaven, and they are willing sometimes we will find situations where we're in conflict or in difficult situations, and we might need to say to the family, but you need to make a choice here. If you go and declare to me yourself, maybe the best place is for you not to be here. Now, I'm not suggesting that the 9-year-old child, but when we're adults, that may be an obvious thing for a family. That may very well be. Now, many people have encouraged to that. All they do out of such violent anger that it becomes irreparable and it becomes totally destructive to any ongoing peace in the family. But he is interested. Now I want to suggest some things that we can do. The first thing I think we can do, and we need to do it, is we need to get connected with God.
So that's it,
Now, some parents would have stopped the children from attending.
We didn't. We were confused by that. Sometimes we'd go after him and laugh, and he'd look at some of the funny things I'd pray for. Johanna went through a stage in particular. She was quite different to Adele, but that's vastly different in some ways. She had keen bargaining eyes. She prayed for keen bargaining. Oh, well. I always remember the members of Kim and Barbie. She put them together and made them a kiss for their first time ever. She's nowhere near getting married yet. I mean, she's 18, almost 19. She's not getting married for a few more years yet. But she talks about weddings all the time. Adele does, and Adele secretly talks with Sarah.
Because we know that it is a blessing. We
But the difference doctors took her to the hospital each day, and the mother cheated him, had already just cheated her a couple of days before. Cut her out of here and pulled it out. They've taken samples from this simple woman here. Don't come near her, Mr. Blake. Trying to explain this. I don't know what actually happened. This is, but we can see things getting here. There's no way. It just disappears. It's just impossible. Physically impossible. I'll tell you something, so he told me about what had done with Ray. And we told him that we thought it was a miracle. This is the news. He said, sometimes only people, Christians like you, we have these things happen. Ray, this is not what we do as much. It's here to say to them, that's a God who cares. And not every time has he done this. Things that we've gone through that other people have been horrified at. But that's part of family too.
Isn't it?
It's all comfortable. If you'd like to go to God with people, please feel free to do so. God of free heart and strike the power of being made of man. But tonight, we want to give you some opportunity to be able to do things for us that are far, far different to what we've already seen. Some of us, Egon, we claim to be your people, and you know us. And you know the things that we've failed. We want to tell you tonight that we'd like to keep those things right. We'd like to change things that we haven't been able to change. We'd like you to be involved with those enemies. Some of us here tonight, they really haven't been familiar with talking with you too much. Haven't understood what it is for you to be a father in the true sense, not the fathers that we've experienced so often that have been instructed wrong. Some of us have experienced bad parenting, some of us have experienced good stuff, but so many of us have been in places we wanted to say to you tonight. We'd like you to come in and to bring change to our lives so that there might be a real powerful sense of being part of your family, that our families will come to a place that they'll be, that they'll be happier, they'll be more fulfilled than I've ever experienced, that in a very powerful way that you'll be involved with this. So we'd like to all invite you to be involved in the areas where we've been mentioned here before. Be able to bring change and be allowed you the ability. We'd simply like to say, God, we're sorry for the times we've messed up and we haven't met you yet. And we'd like to, tonight, to give you permission to be here with us so that we can change. And we can become more like you and become a good part of the family. We'll be truly the daughters and the sons of yours and the bad. God, because if it's not there, we get it together, but away from the wind. they touch